Finally, Beza Joe will find this fabled brush. What? What is this? Please, no. This one will stop looking.
This one has no time for gossip. Your face could curdle milk. Keep walking.
You are here to trade? Not to cause trouble? This one is sorry he must ask, but it pays to be careful, no? Bandits are attacking merchants on the road. Karpusa got smart and hired mercenaries. But they can only do so much. The storm, it causes chaos, disrupts the regular patrols. This makes the bandits bolder. Soon, things will quiet down. Until then, Karpusa's coin feeds a few mercenaries, yes?
Very lucky to survive this storm. Kenarthi smiles upon us. Or perhaps we are just lucky. Either way, Bezerra is grateful.
Greetings.
As part of the Dominion, you will gain security. Old Mary Dominion! For prosperity! For security! For unity! For the Dominion!
She's doing all she can. I'm sure of it. Yes?
I hear your pain, old one. I'm doing what I can.
Windcatcher Plantation depends on the Great Tree, yet it sickens before my eyes. Our fates are like leaves in its branches. Do you see that strange miasma? It appeared on the Great Tree after the hurricane, like a sickness. I've done what I can, but I fear it's not enough. There's a cave directly beneath us. I called a spirit there to heal the Great Tree's roots, but it hasn't returned. Would you see what holds the spirit back, and aid it if you can? I can feel the spirit's frustration. It wants to help the Great Tree, but something prevents it. The spirit is old and powerful. It seeks to move from root to root, aiding the Great Tree as it's able. But it's a healing spirit of singular purpose. It doesn't know how to defend itself. I'm uncertain. If so, the spirit must be protected from harm while it heals the Great Tree's roots. It knows what it must do. The Great Tree Shield Windcatcher Plantation from the winter winds and keeps our settlement shaded from the heat of the summer. Its story entwines with ours. When the wind goddess Kanarthi first traveled across the heavens, legends say she grew tired and rested in the branches of a small sapling before resuming her journey. That sapling became the Great Tree and gave Windcatcher Plantation its name.
Been a Quarma master for over a decade. I'm not afraid to admit when I'm up to my neck in droppings, and I sure could use a hand getting out. Ever try piloting a ship through a hurricane while your entire cargo of Quarma eggs hatch and go bug nuts? Been there. Can't recommend it. After we wrecked, they made a Quarma line toward this cave. I came after them, but they're a bit distracted. They always get surly after hatching, but these Quarma are downright unsociable. I tried to stop them from chewing on those huge roots. They objected. Bumped into a fine-looking tree trunk on my way out. Thought I was done for, but it kept walking. Oh, and Quarma didn't take to it, whatever it was. I heard them munching on it, same as those roots. The little ones seemed scared of it. If you can help the pretty tree trunk do what it needs to do, I bet they'll head back this way. If they'd stop eating those giant roots, they might get better. But I don't blame you if you have to put down a few to save the rest. Just be careful. Nothing fiercer than a crazed Quarma. Not even my sister-in-law.
Yeah.
Arise, Ifrei. The miasma has cleared, yet I sense this begins a new chapter for the Great Tree. Though the creatures gorge themselves upon its roots, this was a passing instinct. They can be taught to strengthen the Great Tree. The Quama will soon learn the cave is their nest and treat the spirit as their queen. Together, they'll guard the cave against intruders who seek to harm the Great Tree. A new story can frighten any creature, until it realizes its role within.
I don't know how I feel about these strange bugs, but if Spinner Beneath doesn't mind, who am I to disagree?
Nasty business, these rats. It is a good thing we have so many cats about. Little pests never stood a chance.
Knowledge is power.
longer than expected. Let's see if it was worth it.
Now you die.
Not now, not ever.
Turn back, Master. This is not the place for us.
This one does not understand. This shrine is supposed to be lit with an ever-burning flame. Perhaps Scheherazade has thrown good money after bad. A simple Khajiit, doing what she can to survive. Scheherazade came to this shrine for guidance. It said the flame gives visions to those who seek it. Answers to unasked questions. Mysteries defined by the stars themselves. And if Scheherazade makes some gold along the way, all the better. This shrine is key to all of these things. It's a shrine to Hermaeus Mora, Daedric Prince of Knowledge. They say if you stare into the fire, all will be revealed. But without the ever-burning flame, there is no way to find the lost books. Tomes, lost to the ages. They're full of secrets from an earlier time. A connection to our past, and a bridge to our future. It doesn't matter what lies the spirit hold. Scheherazade will find those books. While searching for the shrine, a spirit appeared to me and warned me away. Don't you see? Hermaeus Mora rewards the pursuit of knowledge. The spirit is a test to keep lazy seekers away. That's her. It's the lying spirit.
Don't listen to these fools' words. The forbidden tomes must be destroyed. Place them in the shrine's flame, quickly. What? That isn't possible. No matter. I'll rekindle the shrine's fire with my own essence, but you must promise to destroy them. You saw what happens to those who possess the tomes. Then that is a blessing. Once the books begin calling to you, there is little time before they ensnare you completely. Burn the books. Don't let their burden destroy you.
You have the books? Then luck truly favors my path. Do not listen to the lying spirit. This knowledge should be preserved by one who knows how. By this, I mean Scheherazade knows. This one knows the proper care and handling of old texts, also the importance of trade. To you, these books are useless things, but to me, they have value. Hand Scheherazade the books in return for value. Just think, no more spirit to natter at you. An old trinket, but this one always felt it brought her some luck. Perhaps it's what led us to meet at this shrine. A true pleasure. It would be good to meet again, yes? What fortune? Perhaps Sahir Daru should examine her purchase. All this wasted effort. Blasted creatures get into everything. First the hurricane, then rats from the sea. What next, flying mud crabs? Serendar's mercy, we need more time before the inspection. Dominion inspectors. Headwoman Harani requested their aid to stop smugglers. We're honest farmers with good customers. Our moon sugar is used to spice food, not to brew skooma. When the inspectors learn we can't protect our fields, we're finished. Hairy, squirmy, squeaky little rats. They've infested the plantation since the storm. The inspectors will ask, if we can't protect our fields from those dung-dropping sugar-eaters, how can we protect them from skooma-brewing thieves? Find out why Cindertail's cinch tigers roll on their backs instead of filling their bellies with rat. Does one expect to keep his job if the inspectors find vermin in our fields? At best, the inspectors will recommend our moon sugar be confiscated. To the east, a plantation burns. Was it due to the inspector's recommendations? Who can say? Either way, Mistral will weep for our passing. With Laughing Moons gone, skooma will flow through the streets. When moon sugar runs dry, people turn to smugglers. With smugglers come skooma. But the inspectors aren't from here. If we tell them, they will not listen. Find out why Cindertail's cinch tigers roll on their backs instead of filling their bellies with rat. Does one expect to keep his job if the inspectors find vermin in our fields? At best, the inspectors will recommend our moon sugar be confiscated. Ha! You pull this one's tail, yes? A white powder, very sweet, used as spice for food. Some of us believe it gives true insight into Jokajay, where all fates are bound. Others use it to brew skooma. It is not this one's place. The monks at Two Moons Dance might instruct you if you seek them out.
Blazing about like a sun-drunk serpent. To think you were once our greatest hunter. Want to buy a carpet? How about three? They aren't good for much else. Yes, Afe, even you. Do not eat the rats, this one says. Do they listen? No! Stupid cinch. Lazy cinch. They already did. That's the problem. Moon sugar makes you sleepy if you eat too much. Rats eat moon sugar, cinch eat rats, and then lazy cinch. Especially you, Gobani. not with sugar bellies. These useless sedge could only kill a rat if they fell upon it. From a great height. Go inside, lock the doors, wait until they leave? No. Let this one think. Without sedge hunters, what could... Thunderbugs. No, it would never work. Thunderbugs nest nearby. They defend their delicious eggs from anyone who'd make a meal of them, yes? If you grabbed an armload of eggs... Undoubtedly, but they'd hesitate to harm the eggs once you possess them. Smash an egg into each rat nest, and the Thunderbug's electric frenzy kills the rats before the inspectors arrive. You're sturdy, yes? A little shot won't stop you. Wonderful! Save some eggs for Cindertail, yes? They are so very tasty.
There's no question, Jurandara. Your specialists certainly showed the vermin their place.
Of course, Inspector. We could expect nothing less of our specialists.
Haldoril, make a note. Unorthodox methods, but vermin-free.
Sir.
Clever luring Thunderbugs out of their mounds like that. A scheme worthy of Bandar himself. They're all gone, then? Excellent. Our gracious inspector has been most patient with us. Perhaps witnessing your ingenuity will affect his findings. Joan and Joe dance kindly with you, Walker. Whatever the findings of our esteemed inspector, we are in your debt.
If this place remains open, as has yet to be determined, the Clan Mother should hire you in a more legitimate capacity.
Will you be staying with us long, Inspector?
Thank you.
tail.
Greetings. Some of these weapons look familiar.
What do you want? What do you want?
Only the finest wares.